Hi everyone, Ian Van Tuyl here, and behind me is a new listing of mine for a 2018 Jeanneau 519 Sun Odyssey. So let me show you some of the features and benefits that this yacht has to offer. Okay, so here we are looking at the Jeanneau 519 Sun Odyssey, and what makes this really unique is the new bowsprit option here with multiple tack attachment points, and that is a really nice system. Single a bow roller that allows you to have really nice access to the windlass, and just a real beautiful plum bow and great design. This is a Philippe Rion hull design, and he's known for a really powerful, stable offshore cruiser, and that's what we get with this particular yacht. As we come aboard the vessel, you're gonna have a couple different good aspect points here. One thing I wanna point out to you is the large Jeanneau tracks up on the side deck. Now this is set up for a little higher performance, a little bit more sail area, and I'm gonna get to that here in just a second. You also have the jib tracks up here up on the cabin top for a smaller head sail. But as we move up forward, you're gonna notice that the furler is actually below deck. So they're maximizing the sail area. This is a deck sweeper, and it is a really powerful vessel. We have the large Lumar windlass here, a large sail locker that houses your fenders and dock lines, and a great use of space. Working our way back aft, you can again see the really nice flush hatches. Nice, easy, clean decks. This is a whisker pole up here. And then all of our sheets and halyards are led aft into the cockpit. The other thing I want to point out is this is the die-form standing rigging. So again, to tell the difference, is you have the flat edges on it. So this is stronger, less stretch, and really nicely rigged up. Moving back aft, you see a large traveler here and a custom Dodger connector bimini. And as we go into the cockpit, it is pretty impressive for a boat of this size. What I also want to kind of point out is like all of the jib sheets and main sheet get led back to the helmsman. So this is a real easy boat to single hand. Cockpit centrally located, drop down swim platform right here. This is controlled by electric switch. We have our speakers, our emergency bilge pump. We have double shore power cords coming in because we do have air conditioning heating on board. At the port helm, you're going to see a Raymarine multi-repeater. Also, again, you have great access to the Jeanneau track lead adjuster. And then our main sheet, jib sheets, and electric two-speed Harkin winches. Raymarine hybrid touchscreen. And again, really phenomenal visibility when you're sitting here at the helm. Overhead, we even have windows put in so you can see your mainsail. Centrally located in the cockpit table is our quick windlass controller. So this allows us to lower and retrieve our windlass from right here. Then over at the starboard helm, we have a speaker, hot and cold swim step shower, a water inlet. The vessel itself has 42 engine hours on it. So very, very lightly used. Here we have our autopilot display, our hybrid touchscreen, our bow thruster controllers, and again, access to the two-speed Harkin electric winches. But this is a really comfortable cockpit. Below here is the generator, and then you have storage on both sides. You have two large lazarette lockers to both starboard and port side as well, as this beautiful table with the wood leaves that opens up and a great amount of storage below this. We have an electric cabin top off to the port side, manual off to the starboard, and again, all the sheets and halyards are led into the cockpit. The other thing that's nice about this is these opening doors here. They're magnetized in the open position, but we're gonna go down below and I'm gonna show you what the vessel looks like in its natural light. We have the galley off to the starboard side. This is a large three burner stove and oven. This is the T-shaped galley. So what's really unique about this is you can actually have two people working the galley, but it is a real open feel. Tons of storage, drawer space. We have the built-in microwaver, top-loading fridge and freezer with a side access door to the refrigerator. Double stainless steel sinks, lots of cabinetry around. Directly across from us is our dayhead access. So this opens up and you have a sink, full shower, Japsco quiet flush electric toilet. And what's really cool is it's the VIP cabin access. So you have access into the aft cabin. So while we're kind of looking down, this is a pull lever for additional fuel tank. We have our battery switches, our switches for our winches and bow thruster. Large storage hanging locker here. We have aviation style shades for the side ports, but really nice queen size berths here. And there are three overhead opening hatches, starting with here, two and three. LED lighting throughout, really nice hardware, really thick hinges. Everything magnetizes into place, which I really like that. And then directly behind the galley itself is the mirrored cabin. Again, both with plastic still on the mattresses. This vessel is very lightly used and really well taken care of. This salon is pretty spectacular. So, I mean, I challenge most of you, you cannot find a salon this big in a 50-foot yacht anywhere else out there. You'll be looking closer to 60-foot. I mean, the volume and just like how far it is over there, so impressive. This is just a great space to just hang out in and lounge. We have our nav station desk here. We have our VHF, our 110 12-volt controls, fusion stereo, generator start-stop, inverter, on and off switch, and then both of our incoming shore power controllers that are located there. Air conditioning, heating in the salon and in both aft cabins and forward master. The luxury salon table is pretty unique because when it's folded over in this orientation, you have a nice lounge area here, great accessibility into this, and then you can see that it just hinges right over, and you have this huge salon table. Directly across from us is two bench seats and a large storage compartment there. We have additional storage underneath here, silverware drawer, and again, I mean, just a great use of space. Cups, storage, another pull-out drawer here. Tons of storage on this yacht. Moving up forward, as we look kind of at this bulkhead, I just want to kind of point out that this is the louvered bulkhead. So all these small attention to detail items from the handhelds with the leather wrapping here. I mean, look at the hinges that they use. It's just very quality stuff. As we go up to the forward master cabin, we have a little desk vanity here, tons of storage, hanging locker space, storage cabinets all on the top side, a large centerline queen berth. We have aviation shades on both hull ports, two overhead opening hatches above the bed, additional overhead opening hatch as you walk into the stateroom itself. There's a large full-length mirror here. And again, just I can't tell you enough, this that small attention to detail with just the way that they've angled this wood, it really sets this off. Double drawer storage underneath the bed. And again, his and hers hanging locker. Walking into the master head itself, this is the shower compartment. Now the shower has that plexiglass door that'll encompass this shower area. You have the nice teak bench seat here, our sink vanity, and our electric Jabsco quiet flush toilet. LED lights overhead as well. And just a great use of space. Well, I hope you found this video to be helpful and informative. If you like it, please give it a thumbs up. And if you haven't already, subscribe to my channel for additional video walkthroughs like this and see all the latest yachts that are on the market before they even are posted. Again, thank you. I look forward to hearing from you and hopefully earning your business.